Hi everyone, I'm Terri with State Bank of Wynnewood in Wynnewood, Oklahoma, and we're here today in the bank's kitchen, and we're going to make NENE'S chocolate sheet cake. This recipe was given to us by Sherri. So let's get started. To begin with, I have 2 cups of butter that I'm going to melt. And I also have here 1 cup of water, which I'm bringing to a boil. Okay, now that my butter is melted, we're going to add 4 tablespoons of cocoa. And I'm going to give this a quick stir. Now that I have this stirred, I'm going to pour this into our boiling water. And I'm going to let this boil for 30 seconds. Okay, now that this is done, let's remove this mixture from the heat. Okay, now on to step 2 for this cake batter. So now I have here 2 cups of flour, and I'm going to add 2 cups of sugar and 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Let's give that a quick mix. Okay, now let's add our chocolate mixture to this. Okay, now on to step 3 for this cake batter. I have here 2 eggs, which I need to beat. And I did get a little shell in there. And I'm going to add that to 1/2 cup of buttermilk, 1 teaspoon of baking soda, and 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. And stir that really well. Okay, now that I have this mix, I'm going to pour this into our cake batter. And stir this until it's well combined. Sherri told us that she took 3 years to develop this recipe just the way she wanted it, and that she always mixes this by hand. She never uses a mixer. Okay, now we're ready to put it in our pan. Okay, now let's get our pan ready. I'm going to spray it real well. And pour the batter in. Okay, now let's put this in a 350 degree oven and we'll let this cook for 20 minutes. Okay, while our cake is in the oven, let's start making our icing. I have here 1 3/4 sticks of melted butter, and I'm going to add 4 tablespoons of cocoa. I'm going to give that a quick stir, and I want this mixture to come to a boil, and I'm going to let it boil for 30 seconds. I stirred this so that it wouldn't stick. I don't know that it would, but I don't want it to scorch. And now let's pull it away from the burner, and we're going to add a couple more of our ingredients. I'm going to add 6 tablespoons tablespoons of whole milk and 1 tablespoon of vanilla extract. And then I'm going to give that a stir. And I'm going to transfer this to a big bowl that I can stir in. Okay, now I'm going to add 1 pound or 1 box of powdered sugar that I have sifted. Because if you're not careful, this can get lumpy. And I'm just going to take my time and stir this in. We want a smooth icing. Our last step is our pecans, which are optional. And give that a final stir. Now that our cake is done, let's get it out of the oven. Okay, now that I've had this out of the oven for just about 5 minutes, it's time to pour our icing on. Be sure and get the icing all over the cake. This takes a little bit of time. Let's get ready to taste this. I'm gonna clean up my mess here. And you can eat this cake cold or warm. Here at the bank, it never makes it to the cold stage. We like it hot. Let's try a piece. I want to thank you for joining us today, and I especially want to thank Sherri for giving us this recipe. So let's give it a try. Oh my gosh, it is so good. It melts in your mouth. You've got to try this recipe. You can find us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.